Let's see, I have 1.76 yards. You want to convert that to centimeters. So what you do is you take, if you have something like this, 1.76 yards, and you have centimeters, you can't convert directly into meters. You want to convert that into centimeters. First, you want to convert that smaller unit like meters, because you have the unit system. 1.94 yards is equal to 1 meter. So I convert to meters first, because it's telling us that 1 centimeter is 1 by 10 to the power minus 2 meters. Right, you're given the meter system. You're not given the conversion from yards directly to. If they were given, let me say 1 yard is equal to so and so centimeters, then you convert to centimeters. But you had to find a ratio of 1 to yards, 1 meter to yards. So in this case, you convert from yards. Convert that to centimeter to meters first, and then you convert in that to centimeters. Now when you have something like 1.094 yards is equal to 1 meter, that means that you equal to 1 meter, that means that if you bring this across here, you get 1.094 yards divided by 1 meter. If you use this as one factor, you see this whole thing is one factor, then this whole thing is equal to one. It means that it's one of this. It's 1.94 yards over 1 meter. So you use this as one unit. For example, if you have apples and banana, you have two different things. But if you put them together, if you have banana per apple banana, then you consider this whole thing as one. You just use the whole thing as one unit. It's like having one, but this is one divided by 1 meter. This is one ratio of one to one. It's just like having bananas. This whole thing is considered to be one banana, apple banana. So if you consider this whole thing as one, then you can multiply this by anything else, by any number. So you can multiply this by whatever. So what you want to do is, you can multiply this by any unit. So in this case, you want to multiply something that you get rid of the butt, you want to get rid of the yard. So if you put 1.76 and you have to multiply that by this one system, then you put the meter on top and you could put the yard, because it's the same thing. 1.04 yards is equal to 1 meter. So 1 is equal to 1 meter over 1.4 yards. So you could put the yards at the bottom. Yards. Right? Anything you want to convert to, you put that top, and you want to cancel, this will be yards, so that they cancel out. Now you want to convert to meters, so you could continue the process. You want to convert to meters. So we know that 1 centimeter is equal to, so this has a ratio of 1 centimeter for to 1 by 10 to the power minus 2 meters. So you want to get rid of the one that, you want to get rid of the meter. So you put the meter at the bottom, so you put 1 by 10 to the power minus 2 meters. You want to convert the centimeters equal to 1 centimeter. So you want to convert, so you want to cancel. This will cancel with this. This meter here would cancel with this meter, and you're left with these units here. So you multiply these units out. So by 10 to the power of 1. So that cancels with this. So you're left with, when you multiply this out, you get this 1.60 centimeters. Because the centimeters and meters cancel, the yard and yard cancel, so you're left with this. You want to put that as significant figures. When you multiply significant figures, you take the least amount of significant figures. This has 1 significant figure. This has no significant figures. This has 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures. This has 1 significant figure. So The least amount of significant is 1. Is 1. By 10, well, this will be 10. Minus, this will be 1. This will be 10 to the power of minus 2, so this would be 1 significant figure. Because this is 1 significant figure, because this is equal to 0.01. So this has 1 significant figure. 1, 2. So the least amount of significant figure is 1. Right? So the answer is 161 centimeters. Okay, so how are we going to? So you want to convert from inches squared, you want to convert units raised to a power. So you want to convert from inches squared to centimeters squared. So to do that, you find 1 to whatever. So we know that 2.54 centimeters is equal to 1 inch, right? 1 inch. So if you have a good thing like this, a graph, you want to square this, you find the square of that, then if you have two squares like this, then 1 inch would be 1 inch by 1 inch. And this would be 2.54 centimeters is equal to 2.454 centimeters. If you find the square of that, then multiply 2.54 centimeters multiplied by 2.54 centimeters is equal to 1 inch by 1 inch. So when you multiply this out, you get 6.4516 centimeters squared is equal to 1 inch squared. So centimeters is because semi squared, this multiplied this is this. 1 by 1 is 1, inch by inch is inch squared. So that's the answer. 6.456 centimeters is equal to 1 inch squared. So you make 1 squared. Or you can write this as 1 factor of 6.4516 centimeters squared over 1 inch squared is equal to 1. So you have this, you want to use this freely. How did they come up with this? Well, the one you want to find, the one that you have is liters. The one you want to find is the one you want to get to. So to get to 1 inch, you have to get the centimeters first. But to get the centimeters, you have to get the milliliters first. To get the, right? So that's why you have to use milliliters, centimeters, cube, and then inches. You can't get to 1 milliliter is equal to how many inches. It doesn't say. If it said 1 milliliter is equal to 10 something inches, then you can just go directly. But because it says 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters and 1 centimeter is equal to this, then to get to this point, you have to get the centimeters first, and to get the centimeters, you have to get the milliliters first, and for millimeters, you can get the liters. So you use the factor, you have to get the centimeter, to get the milliliters, you have to get the to milliliters, from liters, you have to get the milliliters first, and then from milliliters, you have to get the centimeters. So centimeters is 1 centimeter, say, cube. The one to get to on top over is equal to 1 milliliter. So let's talk about that now. Why is 1 centimeter cube equal to 1 milliliter? Why is, how is this cube and how is this not cube? Well, this is what they did. Let's say you have a square like this, and the square is 1 centimeter, and you have 1 centimeter, and you have a distance of 1 milliliter. Well, 1 centimeter. So, if you find the cube of 1 centimeter cube, it'd be 1 by 1 centimeter cube by 1 centimeter cube, which is equal to 1 by 1 by 1, which is 1 centimeter cube. So you have a cube like this. 1 centimeter cube So what they did was they took a cube. What they did was they took a cube like this. A cube, let's say a cube of water. So you have a cube of water. And the cube is exactly 1 cm by 1 cm by 1 cm. They calculate that to be 1 cm cube. And they said that is equal to 1 milliliter. So they use this conversion factor. So that's why they decided on that 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 milliliter. And you could use that to find any sort of liters. So that, so 1 milliliter cube is equal to 1 liter. Because if you work it out one by one by one, you get 1 cm cube, which is equal to 1 liter. Milliliter. Okay. So you want to convert now from centimeters to inches, because you have the factor of 2.54 centimeters is equal to 1 inch. So we have centimeters, you can use that to find inch. So you want to, when you want to find, you put on top inch divided by, no, inch divided by, um, 2.54 centimeter, right? So now you have this to work with at the end. You want to work at the end here. 2.54 centimeter is equal to 1 inch. But in the question didn't ask, the question wasn't define inches. The question was asked 5.70 liters, convert that into inches cube. So you have to convert this into inches cube. We have to make this, that's how we did the last problem. So what we know is we know that 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 inch cube. So 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 inch cube. No, 2.5 centimeter cube. 1 inch cube. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter cube. So this whole thing is cube. Whole thing is cube. Right? Because if you have a square like this, 1 inch, and a cubit, you get 1 inch by 1 inch by 1 inch. Now the inch, 1 inch is equal to 2.54, so use that for this one. So use 2.54. So now you know this conversion is 2.54. Then this becomes 2.54 centimeter cube. You just leave it as cube for now. Cube. Right. So now we're left with this. 1 inch, 1 inch cube is equal to 2.54 centimeter cube. And you can, you want, so we convert that. We have 5.70 liters. You can, all this is considered to be one in a sense. So now you can multiply this whole thing by 5.70. Well, in this case, 2.570, this is 10 to the power of minus 3 liters. Just like we did the one, this is the whole thing in another one. So this would cancel. Milliliters and milliliters would cancel. Centimeter cube and centimeter cube would cancel. And you're left with, you multiply this out, the cube would cancel, and you get, so when you multiply this out, you get 347.835 inches cube. It's equal to 48, 1, 2, 3 One, two decimal places. One decimal place. One, two, three decimal places. So you round off to three decimal places, you get 348 inches cubed. So you have density as a conversion factor. So you can use density as a conversion factor, but besides that, we were doing that before. We were using a ratio of one milliliter is equal to that's a ratio, that's like a density, that's not really density, but that's the same idea. So you have a jet engine, a jet plane. Before takeoff, it takes 173,231 liters of jet fuel to fly. And what they want to find the mass of the jet fuel in kilograms. Let's say somebody else in the next country uses kilogram. They want to know how much is that in kilogram. Well, given the density is this. How do you use this to find the mass in kilograms? So we know the conversion factor is 1 milliliter is equal to 1000 liter cube. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cube. And density is equal to 0.768 grams per cm cube. That's what I was given. 68 grams per cm cube. But we're not given kilograms. See, we're given grams for every gram per cm cube. Right? But we know that one, even if you're not given kilograms, you first have to convert liters to grams. Because you can say that one, everybody knows that 1,000 grams would give you 1 kilogram. So use this as a conversion factor. Now look at the density. Isn't it not the same thing as this? In terms of, you can write the density. You can write the density as 0.768 grams is equal to 1 centimeter cube. Can you write that? Because if you put this on the bottom, then you could write this as 0.768 grams over 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1. So it's the same ratio conversion factor. That's how density works. So it's the same ratio conversion idea when you do grams. Okay, so now you have liters. You want to get all the way to kilograms, but you can't just jump to kilograms because there's no conversion factor here. There's nothing says that 1 liter is equal to something kilograms. We don't have that, we just jump right into it. So what we can do is we have grams, we have milliliters. For milliliters we can go to we could go to centimeters, because 1 liter is 1 centimeter. And from centimeters, we can go to grams, because they say 1 centimeter is this amount of grams. And from grams, you can go to kilograms, because so you go from liters of what you're given. You can go to milliliters. Then from milliliters, you can go to centimeters cube. Centimeter cube, you can go to grams, and even if this is not given, you know that 1 gram is 1,000 kilograms, so you could go to kilograms, which you want to find kilograms. So we set it up, so we have the thing we have is 1,703 by 231 liters multiplied by. You want to convert to milliliters. The one you want to convert to goes on the top. The one that you No, you can convert to milliliters. I'll convert from 1 milliliter is at 10^12 milliliters. Okay, so you could convert that first as equal. So 1 milliliter goes on top. You want to convert to goes on top is equal to 1 milliliter is equal to 10^-3 liters. You want to go to centimeter, so the one you want to find goes on top, centimeter cube. The one that you have is 1 milliliter. The conversion is 1 centimeter is 1 milliliter. Then you want to go to grams, so the grams go on top. Now look at this one. For the last one, we're not given the conversion, but we're given the density. We're given the density of 0.768 grams is equal to cm cubed. But isn't this the same thing as writing it this way? You can write this like this. So you have a conversion of 1.76 grams over cm cubed, or it's equal to 1. So you can write this density as this. So the one you want to find is grams. So the grams go on top. 768 grams. The one you have goes on the bottom. And that's it. Now you want to convert to kilograms. So the one you want to convert to goes on top. And the one that you have goes at the bottom. Grams. Right? So now this and this would cancel. Milliliters and milliliters would cancel. Centimeter cube and centimeter cube would cancel. Grams and grams would cancel, and I just work this entire thing out. So you're left with 1073 by 231 multiplied by 1/10^-3 multiplied by 1/1 multiplied by 0.768 grams, 76/1 multiplied by 1/1000. The answer. So it works out to be 1.3304. One four zero eight. So no significant figures is rounded up to significant figures. Then you get how many significant figures? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 significant figures. One significant figure. 1, 2, 3 significant figure. 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures. Right, so you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. By 6 significant figures, you have 1 significant figure, 1, 2, 3 significant figure, 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figures. The least amount of significant figures would be 3. Right, so you get 1.33 3 significant figures. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And let's all learn this. Do you want to find the problems of all of the equation? You want to find the radius in cm, radius in cm, and in centimeters, radius in centimeters of a shape water droplet. So you have a water droplet, let's say it's round like this, it's in form of a sphere. So that's the water droplets in the front of a sphere. The volume of a sphere is 4 pi r, 4 thirds pi r cube. And you have the volume is equal to this amount. And we want to find the radius of it. You want to find the radius or in centimeters. So all you have to do is, if you want to find the radius of this, all you do is you put your radius by itself. So if volume is equal to 4 thirds pi r cube, Then you put the radius by itself, and you bring over the 3, bring over the 4, and bring over the 5. So you get 3 volume over 4 pi is equal to r cube. R cube. So now you get radius is equal to 3 volume over 4 pi 1/3. So now you just substitute 3. The volume is 0.058 cm³ over 4 pi by 1/3. This will be equal to 0.24013 cm, right? Which is equal to how many significant figures in the calculation? Because here you have 2 significant figures. Here you have no significant figures, so the only 2 significant figures is 2. So the answer would be 0.2 significant figures, 4 cm. So you just bring this across and you find for r. So you want to find the density in grams cm³ of a metal cylinder, 8.3 grams, length 1.94 cm, radius. So they want to find the density in grams per centimeter cube. So we know that the mass is equal to 8.3 grams. The length is equal to 1.94 centimeters. And the radius is equal to 0.55 cm. So you have the gram and you have the centimeters already. We know that the volume of a cylinder is pi r squared by length. Length, right? That's L for length. So if we want to find the density, which is, now what is density? We know density is equal to mass over volume. So what we do is we use this to find the, we have the mass already. We don't have the volume. We have the mass, we have the radius, and we have the length. So first we want to do is find the volume. Density solution. So you find the volume. So you find the volume is equal to pi radius. Radius is 0.55 cm squared by the length. The length is 1.94 cm. So when you work that out, you get 1.8436 cm. Centimeter and centimeter give you cm³. So now, what is volume? Now we have volume is density, mass over density. Density we know. We want to find density. So that's what I find. So we know the mass. Mass is equal to 8.3 grams. We just found the volume to be 1.8436 cm³. So density is mass of our volume, 8.3 grams over volume, which is 1.8436 cm³. When you work that out, you get 4.50206 grams per cm³. How many significant figures in the calculation we did so far? This one, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5, so the least amount 7 megas is 2, so it's 4.5 grams per cm cube.